Welcome to the GCA Math Reading Rainbow. Today we're going to read Working with Fractions by David Adler. A fraction is a part of something. You can see fractions at birthday parties. If there are 3 red balloons at the party and 10 balloons in all, then a fraction of the balloons is red. 3/10 of the balloons are red. So we have 1, 2, 3 of the 10. If you play musical chairs at the party and 5 out of the 7 children are sitting on chairs, a fraction of the children is sitting. 5/7 of the children are sitting in chairs. So our 7 refers to the entire group, and 5 of that group are sitting. If a pizza pie is served at the party and the pie is cut into 8 equal slices, then each slice is a part, a fraction of the pie. Each slice is 1/8 of the pie. If the birthday cake is cut into 12 equal slices, then each slice is a part, a fraction of the cake. Each slice is 1/12 of the cake. Fractions are not only found at birthday parties. Fractions are also found everywhere. Think of how you use fractions every day. Each time you read a book or a page in a book, you're reading just a part, a fraction of the book. If the book is 96 pages, each page is 1/96 of the book. Coins are fractions too. There are 20 nickels in a dollar. So 20 nickels are the same as $1. Each nickel is a part, a fraction of a dollar. Each nickel is 1 of 20 nickels in a dollar. Each nickel is 1/20 of a dollar. If we skip counts by 10 or 5s, we can see 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60, 65, 70, 75, 80, 85, 90, 95, 100. 20 nickels makes 100 cents or $1. So 1 nickel would be 1/20 of a dollar. Now you know some fractions. You know 3/10, like the balloons, 5/7, like the kids sitting in the musical chairs, 1/8, like the pizza, 1/12, like the cake, 1/96, like the pages of a book, and 1/20, like money. Take a look at 3/10, the fraction of balloons that are red. The 3 tells you we are talking about 3 red balloons. The 10 tells you that we're talking about 10 balloons in all. 3 of the 10 are red, or 3/10 are red. So the denominator, our bottom part, tells us the whole, and the top part tells us the numerator, or part of that whole, in this situation. Take a look at 5/7, the musical chairs fraction. The 5 tells you we are talking about 5 children, the 5 who are sitting. The 7 tells that there are 7 children in all. These children are from this group. Take a look at 1/8, the pizza slice fraction. The 1 tells you we are talking about 1 slice of pizza. The 8 tells you we're talking about 8 slices in all. Each fraction has a top number and a bottom number. The top number of the fraction is the numerator, the bottom number is the denominator. But what we really need to think about is how the numerator and denominator are put together to make a number. 5/7 is a number. 3/10 is a number. Fractions are numbers just like whole numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. If the fraction 3/10, the numerator is 3, the denominator is 10. In 5/7, we have the numerator 5, the denominator 7. In 1/8, we have the numerator as 1 and the denominator is 8. What happens when the numerator or the denominator changes? What if 5 of the balloons at the party are red? Earlier we had 3 of the balloons red, but now we have 5. So then 5/10 of the balloons are red. 5 is more than 3. So 5/10 is more than 3/10. And we could write that like this. We could have 5/10 is greater than 3/10. And as we read this story, really carefully pay attention to the fact that when we're comparing these fractions, they're easy to compare because the denominators are the same. We have more of that same group. What if 6 of the children in the game of musical chairs are sitting? Then 6/7 of the children are sitting. 6 is more than 5. 6/7 is more than 5/7. So we only have one child that's still standing. And in a little bit, we'll talk about what if all of the 7 were sitting. That would mean the entire group. What if you ate 2 slices of pizza? If you did, you ate 2/8 of the pizza pie. 2 slices are more than 1 slice. 2/8 is more than 1/8. This is really important. The larger the top number of a fraction, the larger the numerator, the larger the fraction. So if we had 2/8, it is larger than 1/8. But the key component set is when the denominators, the bottom numbers, are the same. If these denominators are not the same, this is not necessarily true. If the denominators are the same, and you have 2 of that same group, and you're talking about same size pizzas, then 2 is greater than 1. Now, if we change that, and what if we had a large pizza and a small pizza, and we divide, whoops, my line was a little off there, we have 1/2. 1/2, I think it's off kilter a little bit there, 1/2 of this pizza is definitely larger than 1/2 of the other pizza, even though we're saying half and half. So we have to talk about things that are the same size when comparing fractions. At the birthday party, what if the pizza pie was not cut into 8 equal size pizzas? What if it was cut into 10 equal size slices? Because more slices were cut from the pie, each slice would get smaller. Each slice would be 1/10 of the pie. The fraction 1/10 is smaller. So let's write that. Here we have 1/10. And because there's more pieces, you can see that that piece is smaller than 1/8. So even though if you looked at the 10 and isolated all by itself, you would think, oh, 10's bigger than 8. So 1/10 must be bigger. But when you think about the denominator and that there's more pieces, and we're talking about the same size whole, actually, 1/10 is smaller than 1/8. At the birthday party, what if the cake was not cut into 12 equal size slices? What if it was cut into 15 equal size slices? Because more slices were cut from the same cake, each slice would be smaller. So here in this cake, it's cut into 12 pieces. Over here, it's cut into 15 pieces. What happened when we cut it into 15? You can see the pieces got smaller. So 1/15 is smaller than 1/12 of the same size cake. You see both of them are the same size. But the larger the denominator, the smaller the piece. And that's exactly what this says. It says the larger the bottom number of the fraction, the larger the denominator, the smaller the fraction, when the numerators, the top numbers, are the same. So again, this is the key part. When the numerators are the same, we have 1/12 is greater than 1/15 because there's a 1 here and a 1 here. So we automatically can tell that our numerator, even though it's, or denominator, even though 12, when you think of it by itself, is smaller than 15, it's really bigger because the pieces are larger. Folded sheets of paper and crayons. So right now what I'm going to do is encourage you to get a piece of paper because we're going to talk about something you can do at home. So if you get a folded sheet of paper and crayons, it can teach you a lot about numerators and denominators. So here's a piece of paper that is folded into 1/4. They folded it right down the middle this way and right down the middle this way. So 4 equal pieces. Each piece is 1/4. Now, We can also take another sheet of paper and we can color that or that same group and color 3 of the 4 red and color 1 of the 4th blue. If you take a look at the red and blue sections, the red part, 3/4, is larger than the blue part, 1/4. Now, you can see the denominator is the same. We have a 4 here and a 4 here. So now we're thinking about, okay, 3 pieces is greater than 1 piece of that same size whole. So we have 3/4 is greater than 1/4. So the larger the top number of a fraction, the larger the numerator, the larger the fraction when, this is the most important part, when the denominators are the same size or the same. So we have a 4 here and a 4 here. So that's what makes it us able to compare those. Now let's take another sheet of paper. We have 1/2. We're going to fold it right down the middle. 1/2 here and 1/2 here. So that crease down the middle shows you each section or 1/2. So let's shade 1/2 green. Okay, so now let's look at those two papers. We have the one divided into 4 equal pieces and the one divided into 2 equal pieces. The blue section is 1/4 of the first sheet is smaller than the green section 1/2 of the second sheet. 1/2 or 1/4 is less than 1/2. Now you'll notice the denominators aren't the same anymore. We have a 4 here and a 2 here, but our numerators are. We're talking about one piece of each. So it's very important we look at those numerators. One of something that's cut into 4 pieces is going to be smaller than one of the same size whole when it's only cut into 2 pieces. You can play tricks with fractions. If a birthday cake is cut into equal size slices, each slice is the same, but 1/12 of one birthday cake might be more than 1/12 of another cake. Do you see that we have different size plates here? So that could be your clue. Just like we talked about, a large pizza and a small pizza really can't be compared because they're not the same size whole. 1/12 is more than 1/15 of the same cake, but 1/12 of one birthday cake might be less than 1/15 of another cake. 1/12 of a cake might be less than 1/15 of a large cake or a small cake. So when we're talking about small and large, we really can't compare. Sometimes the same fraction has different names. So let's use paper plates this time. It says take 2 white paper plates. Let's pretend that each plate is a birthday cake. Before you cut the cake, you decide to serve 1/2 of it at the party and save the other half for later. But now with a ruler and a pencil, you can draw lines to cut the cake into 12 equal pieces and shade those. And you can see when you do this that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 twelfths is the same as 1/2. So originally we had 1/2, but we cut that 1/2 into equal size pieces. 1/2 and 6/12 represent the same amount. They are equivalent fractions. Now let's think about pennies and nickels. 5 pennies are 5/100 of a dollar. So here's our 5/100, and we would count by ones to get 100. If 1 nickel is 1/20 of a dollar, they're both worth 5 cents. So 5/100 is the same as 1/20. They are equivalent or equal. Now let's think about fractions a little bit differently. It says 8/8 looks like a fraction. Right here we have a numerator of 8 and a denominator of 8. This fraction, it is a fraction. It shows 8 of 8. But it also represents the number 1 or 1 whole because we have the entire thing. We're talking about all 8 of the 8 or 1 whole. 12/12 looks like a fraction, and it is a fraction, but it also has another name. It can be also represented as the number 1. Think of a pizza pie that has been cut into 8 slices. Each slice is 1/8 of the pie. If you ate all 8, or 8/8, you would have eaten the whole pie. pie. Think of that birthday cake that's been cut into 12 slices. Each slice is 1/12 of the cake. If you ate all 12 slices, you ate 12/12 of the cake, or one whole cake. 12/12 equals one whole. What happens when you multiply any number by 1? The number that you start with and your answer are the same. So we have 5 times 1 is 5. 8 times 1 is 8. 12 times 1 is 12. When we multiply by 1, we call that the identity property. The number keeps its same identity. It's almost like it's looking in a mirror. 5 turns into a 5. 8, when you multiply by 1, turns into an 8. So that also happens when you multiply fractions by 1. The fraction you start with and your answer are the same. 6/6 is a different form of the number 1. And sometimes I even like to draw a number 1 around my fractions like this when they have the same numerator and denominator. So when we multiply 1/2 times 1, it doesn't look like it just looked in the mirror, but 6/12 is another name for 1/2. Do you remember that pie or paper plate and we cut it in 1/2 into 6 pieces? So 1/12 equals 1/2 equals 6/12. They are equivalent. They look different, but we're still talking about the same size. You can find lots of different names for the same fraction. Just multiply the numerator and the denominator by the same number. Just multiply the fraction by 1. Now remember, even though this doesn't look like a 1, 3/3, because the numerator and the denominator are the same, is the same as 1. So 1/4 times 3/3 equals 3/2. It's like a magic show. Our 1/4 now looks like 3/2, but they're technically the same amount. Can you find the 5 different names for 1/2? Can you find 3 different names for 1/3? So let's think about 1/2. If we were to divide this again, we could see that 1/2 is the same as 2/4. If we divide our whole again, here's our 1/2. We can see that it's the same as 1, 2, 3, 4/8. So on a piece of paper, you can do the same thing, and you can use bar models or circle models and find different names for different fractions. Think about fractions. Once you know fractions, you can work with them. You can add and subtract fractions. To add fractions, when the denominators, the bottom numbers, are the same, you simply add the numerators, or the top numbers, and write the answer over the denominator. So for example, if we have 1/8 of a piece of pizza plus another 1/8, we now have 2/8. The denominator stays the same. 1 plus 1 is 2. 8 plus 8 is not, even though if we looked at those numbers isolated, we would say 16. But we're still talking about this whole. We have 2 of the 8 now. We don't have 2 of the 16. If you ate one slice of birthday cake, you ate 1/12 of the cake. If you ate a second slice, you ate 1/12 more, or 2/12. To subtract fractions when the denominators are the same, and that's the key, are the same, you simply subtract the numerators and write your answer over the denominator. At the birthday party, if you asked for 3 slices of pizza, you asked for 3/8 of the pie. If you ate just 2 slices, you ate 2/8 of the pie. You would have 1 slice left. 3/8 take away 2/8 is 1/8. And you can see we have 3 take away 2 is 1, and our denominators stay the same. an 8 refers to 3 of the 8. We took away 2 of those 8, so now we have 1/8. At the party, if you ask for 2 slices of birthday cake, you ask for 2/12 of the cake. If you ate just 1 slice, you ate 1/12. So we have 2/12. You ate 1/12. Now you have 1/12 left. Fractions are at birthday parties. Fractions are at football games. Fractions are at shoe stores. Fractions are in clothing stores. People use fractions to tell time. People often use fractions. Fractions are everywhere. So when you think about things, and the next time you go shopping, look for fractions. The next time you tell time, think about how every time the hand moves around the clock, we have a fourth of an hour, a half of an hour. And so think about where all you see fractions when you cook or when you do your daily things. We have 1/4 a cup of sugar or 1 teaspoon of salt. So I hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time.